Hello again. Today I'm here for the last time with my stadium truck that I built as an alternate model of the Lego Technic Land Rover Defender 42110 that I designed for 2019. And I didn't promise anything, but I managed to motorize it actually quite simply. I'm not gonna make a full tutorial video, I'm just gonna show what you need to remove and how to simply build the engine block. And I hope that should be enough. So first of all, the reason why I motorized it is that I really wanted to do that, but I just simply didn't have time. And B, I got a hopefully good idea for another alternate build, which I'm not gonna tell you yet what it's supposed to be. So I need the model to be disassembled again. And before doing that, I decided to put some motors in it. And right now, if I show you the bottom, you can see that it still has all-wheel drive with central diff. The only thing that moved actually is that you need to push the central differential to the very end and rotate it with the 16 tooth gear wheel side to the rear. And then you have two large motors for drive and one large motor for steering that is actually placed at an angle, because there was not enough space to fit it above the differential, and I simply didn't want to revamp the whole build. So it's connected to the universal joint that is just sitting behind the front axle. For controlling the model, I'm using the updated Powered Up app. Right now it looks like this. So you have two sliders basically and the speedometer, one for driving back and forth and one for steering. Left and right, and the speedometer basically tells you how much power are you using from the motor. The custom app looks like this. It's not the only option how to do it, but I think it's the simplest one. And thanks to the video by Racing Brake, I was actually able to finally figure out how to reverse the steering, which is basically not very intuitive. So you have to go to this white bookmark and find the widget with the multiply button. Then you put the input and then you just type in -1, which means it reverses the function. For whatever reason as well, the sliders that are marked as the return to center one do not respond to the function. So I just figured out that you need to use the button with two buttons basically as the widget for the sliders with return to center. But other than that, it works afterwards totally fine. When you switch back, it just calibrates the steering and you can drive your vehicle. Here you can see the car's performance outdoors, how it handles over some obstacles and as well in terrain. And you can as well see the suspension in action, which totally makes sense for this motorized version. So right now, quickly, the things that need to go from the cab so you can make up the space for the three motors and the hub. The 5-gallon jug for the spill oil and whatever. Then the seat needs to be removed. You need to remove the whole mechanism for the hand of God steering. I have only a fraction of it because I needed to reuse some of the two module cross axles for the motorization. And the whole gearbox needs to leave the cab. Otherwise, you can leave the model pretty much untouched. The exterior is not changed at all. And right now, I'm gonna show you how to put the motors in. To access the inside, you actually need to remove these side sections of the cab, which is not very difficult. It's holding by two connectors over here and here at the back. Yeah, you can take out the A-posts off. Then you need to pull out these ones, remove the L-beams, and pull the rear section of the cap out together with the rest of the roof. And that's pretty much how it is right now. And here you can see the battery box with the three motors. Yeah, to put as well in and out the battery box, you need to actually remove the side sections. So I recommend highly that you charge the batteries before you place it in. But afterwards, it's just a matter of removing the side and then pulling out this section. And here it reveals the two 5.5 modules cross axles, and the buildup is the same on both sides. When you pull out both the 5.5 module cross axles, then you can easily just slide the battery box out. And I use A, B for the driving ports and D for the steering one. And then you can, from the leftover parts, just attach the 2.7 module beams in olive green, which will enable you to lock it afterwards against these small L-beams, the gray ones with the cross holes through which the 5.5 module cross axles go. To attach the steering motor, I actually built very simple attachment. There are two sections that are totally identical on both sides, and afterwards you have the brace to which you attach the motor by means of these two connectors. So you pull four of these ones out. They are in the inventory of the spare parts. And these sections are not the sturdiest ones because they basically rely on half module of friction, which is not much. But you basically take these two gray connectors and two module lift arms in blue, slide them symmetrically on both sides of this connector, and you put the axle pin inside the snap hole. You repeat that for both sides. And this is how the middle section looks. So it's basically cross axle extenders, two module cross axles, then angle connector number two in black, and again this very same dark gray connector with two cross axles on both ends, and then this three module white connector, and again two module cross axle with an extender. For placing the steering motor in, just make sure that you have the front axle steering centered. Then you can just pull it out, and it will probably be visible from the bottom that it's just attached to this universal joint above the main drive shaft. And I just use two module cross axle in the motor shaft. The driving two large motors are afterwards connected to an 11 module beam and a section of cross blocks and beams, to which you will connect a 16 tooth gear wheel that is going to sit just right above the differential, and two 16 tooth gear wheels on the side and two free running 16 tooth gear wheels in red color. To get this section with the driving motors out, you need to actually pull out at least one of the sides of the drive shaft, as well these two 5 module cross axles with stop. You can as well see that there are new built-in attachments for the motors that keep them in the place. One of them is this gray connector, and the other one is the light gray 3 module long connector with the perpendicular holes. The build is totally symmetric, so there is nothing really fancy about this. So let's get this one out. Yep, and I think right now if I just push up, the motors should detach with the whole section that drives it. It's a bit fiddly to get it out, so I'm just gonna remove the steering wheel, and that's it. And you can see as well some nice grass on one of the 16 tooth gear wheels that is there from driving outdoors. And basically the engine block looks like this. So you take out the two large motors, then you have an 11 module beam, two black pins, and these four module cross axles with a stop over here. That way the cross axles can't just wander out of the drivetrain. Here at the other side you have a 7 module beam with 4 black pins, like so. And then there is this section, which is almost symmetric. So you have these two dark gray connectors. Then you have two module lift arms on each side. And then the central section is on a 5 module cross axle. So one of these dark gray connectors. And then this orientation really doesn't matter. You just need the spacing, 3 modules between the two holes. And you have these two guys sitting on the cross axle. And then for the rest, you can simply take out the small L beams, and then there's two free running gear wheels that are sitting on the 3 module cross axles with a stop, 5 module cross axle for the main driving 16 tooth gear wheel, and that's pretty much it. So this way you should be hopefully able to motorize your stadium trucks if you want to. That's all from my side. Hope you are going to find this useful. Leave a comment if you feel like. Hit the thumbs up button. If you are new to my channel, do not forget to subscribe so you do not miss out on any of my future content. As well, feel free to hit the notification bell. That way you get notified as soon as I upload a new video. And I'm hopefully gonna be here soon again with some other alternate tutorials and some other LEGO related stuff. Take care, stay safe, and bye bye.